So this is maybe quickly about the new Phantom HUD. Now I'm flying a Japanese plane, Japanese Phantom, as you can see. It didn't previously have CCRP or CCRP in sim bounds, but now it's got the new HUD, it actually does. It's a bit strange. Now the dots rotate around the gun sight, tell you the attitude. So the two dots indicate what's going up, which is like this, and going what's down. So there's an attitude indicator, tells you the right angle. There'll be a thing that goes around the sides, which will tell you the distance to drop. So if I were to go to bomb sight mode and go CCRP, so I'm playing with that rod pills right now, and when the line reaches the bottom, it will drop. So I double clip there. But as you can see, the first one will hit the target. A bit off, that's fine. And if I go CCRP mode, I'm tearing so tight with fucking 8 bombs in my plane. See, that CP mode still hasn't changed much. I was using the wrong gun sight, wrong sight. But anyway, I'm trying the ships. There isn't really an indication, it just moves the entire sight altogether. And as you can see, it shifts off the sight limit. So it'll be a bit difficult to use at first. I recommend just going with CCRP, it's easier. Now I believe there was also distance range for Sparrow missile launches. So I'll just lock this plane up. And it's got the range on the outside of the gun sight. As you can see, it's a lot thicker now. I think in a real gun sight there was just tabs on the outside, but we don't get that on the American one for some reason. I also believe the Sparrows and the thing has been buffed. It didn't really animate there. It animates for the SU-17 or CCRP range at least. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't work right now. Where's the other plane? I don't know, there's another plane around here somewhere. There it is. I believe it was mainly the British family that got the lockdown shut down. So it just makes the border thicker, I guess. Doesn't actually. Oh no, it is changing. So the line tells you until when you pass the plane, I guess. It only goes to like 2 kilometers probably. So this is 2 kilometers, this is 1 kilometer, and this is where you meet when you pass the target. And now let's try CCRP with guns. It's not giving me an indication. Well, that's that. With the Russian gun sight, it's a bit different, but still similar. My computer's not running, liking my performance right now. See what's draining my CPU right now. Why is my computer out of memory? What's going on? Alright, there we go. Yellow gun sight, that's what it is. In real life, there was also a static HUD like similar to what the MiG-20 has in DCS, supposedly. So, wings are automatic. At first, you don't need to worry about them. As you go faster, they'll retract. SU-17 only has an indication for the new missiles, which I don't own because I haven't researched them yet. But it has an indication for CCRP. So if you look at the sight, you see there's an arrow that tells you the roll angle. It only works to your closest 30 degrees, unfortunately, which is a bit of a weird choice. I guess it's, someone told me it's to help align missiles. Now I believe these don't work with the gyro. It's just like an ordinary gyro as normal. Yeah, it's a normal gyro, so there isn't any like change. As you can see. Doesn't even give you range indications, nothing like that. Now go to air ground. You see there's two things on the right. Honestly, they don't make much sense, but basically they're still 1 meter. It just, the thing that covers it and it gets close to the top. When you're closer to ground, you can see it rises and rises. So the major markings are 1 kilometer blocks. So I assume this is 3 kilometers and a half. See, my wings are retracted right now. This plane actually moves quite well. It's actually better than SU-7, and it actually has a higher G-load tolerance as well. I tested earlier, it sustained at least 12 Gs. SU-7 is like, what, 10 Gs? So I'm gonna do a quick pull test. As you can see, it sustained 13 Gs, no problem. I was doing an F-14 kind of spin because I'm G-locked. And, yep. Okay, 200 knots. This is pretty slow, but maneuverability is actually pretty decent. It's like an F-14 in DCS when it was released. This is going to be an interesting plane to fly out. It's like another MiG-19. Ooh, G-lock. If I didn't G-lock, I probably would have made it out of that one. Now, the final new HUD I'll be going through is Ford A7, which is a really good fighter. I had my first sim game earlier from the patch drop, and A7 just littered the skies. Air Force strafing, and I said, it'll be harder airfield strafe, and they removed airfield bombing rewards, but that's pretty much wrong. Still, people still bomb the airfield regardless. So this is the new ASIM HUD. So you can see it's pretty modern, but like the problem is still missing quite a lot of things. For example, this is supposed to be your vector indicator, which is supposed to be down here, showing that I'm moving forwards. But this is your airspeed. It's supposed to move the scale and not the line. The right is supposed to be your altimeter or an arrow indicating your descent or climb rate. I'm going to fix the parallax error problem they had on the helicopters. The downside is this little diamond in the middle that moves, it's basically gyro. And it changes indication for CCRP. As you can see, the HUD doesn't really animate, it's kind of like, yeah, incorrect. But you still can sort of read it. If you look here, this is one for I believe 2,000 feet, and these are this is a feet scale. This is knots. So I'm doing 380, 390 knots. So I think that's how Gadget has presented here. But as you can see, this thing is still not working. At the top, you have the compass. This is your altitude roll indication over here. Now, something that Gudgeon did sort of miss out on is that the length of these lines on the sides determines how far above or below the horizon. So they're supposed to get more aggressive if you go like towards 90 degrees. But they're pretty much constant. That's fine. It's not a big deal. You still got the numbers to read out. It just means. It just means if it's zoomed out worse, you can't really see. You can't really read it as well, especially when you're like in aggressive maneuvers like this. But one thing it does do is track around the vector indicator, which is true, but the vector indicator is supposed to show your vector, which is kind of not working. You can see, aggressive maneuvering doesn't change around. And that's pretty much all I have to show for this video.